Hi guys, I'm Arman, I'm 2D animator, I'm specialized in games, and in this channel I'm sharing some cool stuff that I think might be interesting. This is the first video from the series where I will be rigging and animating from scratch, and at the end we will have characters looking like this. Those I have done for Social Point, and we will make some basic animation like walking, jumping, attack and some stuff, maybe some cool VFX at the end. If you are interested, make sure you are subscribed to not miss any upcoming videos. Okay, let's see who we got here. We got Tracer from Overwatch. I downloaded this image from internet and cleaned it up in Photoshop. I hope I won't have any issues with the license, since this video is only for educational purposes. I'm not going to sell or share this project anywhere. Sorry guys. Okay, with this I have played with some animation and rigging them, making some work, but we will be doing this from scratch. So let's start from Photoshop. In Photoshop we have a character already cleaned up and separated into the layers and named them appropriately. I think this is enough for me to start rigging. Well, I already tried, I think it works best. Here are the parts, so you can see them. Nothing much complicated, just so we can concentrate on the main concept of the rigging and animating. Before starting any process in the spine, I would like to share some tips in Photoshop regarding to this process, like separating layering, because a lot of artists were asking how is the best way for animators to clean up. Here are some tips from me. And first tip would be, if you have some parts that are curvy or like tentacles, hair or some clothes, and you think they are going to be animated in spine, after designing them, please provide another version where it is straightened, like this one. And if you are an animator and you already got this kind of part and you want to straighten it up by yourself, I can suggest several tricks. First would be puppet warp. You just set some joints and manipulate it accordingly. It's very easy to use and it's very little destructive. Next, if you want to clean this up, make much straighter, you just use a liquify filter of the Photoshop and adjust it accordingly. You have show backdrop here, you can enable and disable to see the changes real time. After this, or maybe before, there is another tool. This is similar to liquify, only one tool of the liquify, but it's much more destructive. So you can see that it allows to refill the part, like stretch the object, but it makes it blurry. Next tip is about changing color. Sometimes you may need to change part of the character, and for that we know that with Control U we can open hue saturation window where we have the sliders. I'm not going into details, but what if we want to change some particular color, like this orange color? For that we have this tool. With that we can select it. It opens a range where we can adjust it. And after that, if we move the sliders, it will only affect this range. So this way we can make it blue or green, whatever color we want. And the next tip would be, if for example we want to apply same settings to this arm. For that we open the same dialog, but with Alt additional K held for Control Alt U. This will open the same dialog, but already applied these settings. And to quickly navigate between layers and select transform them, I normally use this option, auto select layer and show transform controls. This allows me to, without any hotkey, to quickly jump between the layers and select them, manipulate them however I want. And this has a drawback. If you want to select part of the groups, this is the group, and you want to move the whole group, you can't just drag the group. But we have hotkey, you can select, and with control button key on the keyboard pressed, you just drag it. When you are cutting parts and you know how they are going to behave in spine, for example, this arm has a joint, obviously, you can try it in Photoshop, test it. For that, just enter in transformation mode and with Alt key held, just move the pivot point where you think it would be best. Now you can rotate and test it. And my suggestion is to the finish endings of the parts in circular way. Those work best in my experience. Now, when we have finished cutting, we need to make sure that all layers are named properly. Those names will be used in spine by animator, and the bones will share same name. So make sure they are meaningful and they are unique, otherwise you won't be able to export. And when I say export, I mean script that was done by spine for Photoshop. There are also other versions for Illustrator and other image editing tools. This script I have already installed and I can find it in scripts and Photoshop to spine. I have also assigned shortcut here so I can quickly bring it up and see the settings. I'm not going to cover them. Just know that there is a help button which opens some instructions. They are very important. You can use them to make animator life easier. Here I have an example of making it. Here you can see ignore. This means that this group will not be exported and everything inside it. And another trick is if you want to assign this kind of tags to other layers or groups, there is an easy way. You can assign an action for that and assign a key to that action, and you just can press the key and assign any tag you want. The last thing we need to do before saving this PSD into our project directory is to set up a root point, the ground point for the character. Make sure the ruler is enabled in Photoshop with Ctrl R. Drag from the left top corner from the box and set a nice ground point. This point will be used in spine to align character to its root bone. And as I know, this point is only being saved in current session. So if you close the Photoshop and reopen it, you will need to set the point again. So let's export it. Let's save the Photoshop file and export it. I'm hitting Control Alt Shift Q, my shortcut to this script. And with those settings, I think, yeah, I like them. I hit OK. Okay, now let's go and see what we have. Let's open Spine. And when I exported, it created JSON file, which is text file that knows where to place every image that is exported. So I just drag that file into the spine and it opens import data window. Here we can just say that create a new project and import. No, we don't want to save this. Okay, we have the character. Let's save it. And that was it for today. Make sure you have subscribed to not miss the next video about the rigging and maybe some basic animation. See you, bye.